वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, इन साइंस लेक्चर लेसन टू इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर इट्स ऑब्वियसली अबाउट मैटर्स, सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस व्हाट इज अ मैटर इज, दैट इज पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड ऑक्यूपाइंग स्पेस इज कॉल्ड एज अ मैटर। नाउ फर्दर मोर, मैटर is in the form of an mixtures. In this particular chapter we are going to start with the topic of mixture. So what are mixtures? So mixtures are you are seeing in your surrounding many different kind of mixtures which are there. We are going to discuss with experiment also, okay, what are mixtures. Basically, first of all, we try to understand what is a mixture in form of its definition. Mixture is formed by two or more substances or elements, I would say compounds or elements combined to form a new form a substance which is basically not having any kind of chemical change. They are just remaining physically with respect to each other. So therefore the ratios are also not necessarily should be maintained. Like in water molecules, 2 hydrogen 1 oxygen is necessarily supposed to be there, but in sugar solution, when we speak as a sugar solution need not to be precise that what amount of sugar should be there to make a sugar solution. It can be more also or it can be less also. Like you make a sharbat at your home, so the sharbat can be more concentrated or less concentrated. Such type of things which mix together are called as mixtures, but they are not combining chemically. You have so what are the basic characteristics of mixtures are? So elements or compounds physically mix to form a mixture shows no chemical change. Fine. So first of all they mix together, but they remain participate in only the physical state. That means they remain together in a physical state, but they are not combining to form a new substance. That is, a chemical reaction is not happening. Most nature substances are mixtures, generally exist as mixtures of two or more pure components or substance mixed in any ratio. Like suppose if you are drinking soda, so soda water is dissolved inside, carbon dioxide is dissolved inside the water, so you have the bubbling sensation of carbon dioxide on your tongue with respect to water, and they remain together. They are not combining chemically. It can be more concentrated also and it can be less concentrated. That means the carbon dioxide, sometimes you drink a soft drink, it may be more concentrated and sometimes it may be less concentrated. So it can happen. So in the same way, as I given you the example of sugar solution, maybe of the salt solution also, a salt solution, that is water, the salt is put inside the water and dissolved. It can be more concentrated, it can be very salty, or it can be less salty. So the composition is not fixed, ratio is not fixed. Mixtures retains properties of the constituents. That means that can be identified. These two things which is in the form of a mixture can be identified, whether it is if you drink it, you have always understand it's a salt solution. And if you are given a same two transparent solutions, one is a salt and one is a sugar, by tasting it you can identify whether it is a salt solution or sugar solution. That means water retains its property, salt retains its property. Here also water retains its property, sugar retains its property. Retains means to keep their own properties intact. Mixtures can be separated into components by any physical methods. By physical methods, generally it can be separated, like distillation process, by crystallization process, by this kind of processes they can be separated, physical processes. Generally in nature, two types of generally bifurcation is seen, that is on homogeneous mixtures or heterogeneous mixtures. So this is what it is for mixtures. Now in case of mixtures, you can say alloys are also basically mixtures only. They are also a form of a mixtures. Generally they are homogeneous mixtures, seen whether sometimes it is called as an heterogeneous mixtures also, but they are mixtures. So they are metallic mixtures, both of them are in the solid condition. That can be two metals or more than two metals participating, or maybe a non-metal also which is participating, are called as an alloys. Examples of common alloys, that is a steel is a common alloy that we are using. It's a combination of iron plus carbon. Carbon is a non-metal, so it's a metal plus non-metal. That's a one combination we have seen. Bronze is a combination of two metals, that is zinc and tin. Their proportion might change, so the alloy properties might change. That's why it is called as a mixture. So if you see a bronze, it is slightly whitish, then tin is more and zinc is less, and otherwise the zinc is more and tin is less, vice versa it is there. Even brass, pital, that we speak out in our common language, contains 70% of copper and 30% of zinc. It's a mixture of two things. Bronze is a combination of basically copper and tin, and brass is a combination of copper and zinc. So in case of copper, if copper is more, then a brownish color pital that you have seen it very commonly, brass, that is all vessels are there for the brass in the home also. Now if you see the brass, if it is more yellowish by its nature, that is brownish kind of a thing, that means copper proportion is more. If it is whitish, then it is zinc proportion is more. So likewise, you can identify amount the proportion of either zinc is more or copper is more. If it is whitish, then zinc is more. If brownish, then copper is more. So this is called as an alloy. It's basically a mixture. Now bifurcation of homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures. Now what we understand as homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures, homogeneous mixtures have uniform composition throughout the mixture, and heterogeneous mixtures do not have uniform compositions throughout the mixture. Fine. Secondly, that means if I explain it, like if a salt, so you are drinking a Pepsi or a Coke, that if you drink a first sip or a last sip, you find the same taste throughout. That shows that it's an homogeneous mixture. That means the composition is distributed uniformly throughout. Fine. If it is an heterogeneous mixture, you will not have such kind of behavior seen. If you dissolve a sand in water, you will say it is going to settle down after a few minutes of time. That means it's an heterogeneous mixture. Basically, why? Because the composition is not uniform anymore. The whole mixture. Second point is the whole mixture is in the same phase. Same phase means you find it is in either everything is in the liquid form only, whether though the particles of solid salt is dissolved inside, but you seeing it, you find it's a single phase, it's water only. The substance can be of two phase or layers can be separated. This is found in heterogeneous condition. Like if you keep a marble powder, that is limestone powder, or a chalk powder inside the water and dissolve it, you find that the powder after certain times, maximum of it settle down, some of them remains at the slightly above level and very few particles are roaming around. So this type of mixtures are having more than two phases. Like you are able to identify this into solid form and liquid form also. In the same case, if you put any kind of liquid inside, like oil, if you put inside the water, you find that the phases are separate and they are not mixing it. Even the kerosene and petrol. If you mix it, kerosene and petrol thoroughly, you leave it out, you see after a few minutes of time the kerosene and petrol are getting separated. Fine. The components are not visible to the naked eyes in case of homogeneous mixture, whereas in the case of an heterogeneous mixture, the particles are seen. As I told you, you are not able to identify the salt particles present inside the water. But in case of sand, if you put inside the water, you are able to identify the particles present separately, both of them. Alloys, as we have seen before, alloys and solutions are homogeneous mixtures, right? Alloys and solution. Alloys are, as we understood, is a combination of two or more than two metals or non-metals. It's an homogeneous mixture. It is uniform. Like if you see a gold particle, gold and silver, if you mix it, that we say it's an 22 karat gold. Why? Because certain part of silver is mixed inside to make it hard. And if it is mixed, then means the silver is uniformly distributed inside the entire solution. So it's an basically homogeneous mixture. And the solution, as in salt solution, we have seen. Second is an heterogeneous. Our colloids, emulsion and suspension are heterogeneous mixtures. Colloids, we'll discuss it later on the part of our chapter. Emulsion is a mixture of oil and water. You see oil and mixture getting separated very easily after a few minutes of time if you keep them settle around. Even the suspension that we talked about, chalk powder mixing inside the water, right? Colloidal particles that we can take as milk inside the water is a colloidal particle, but it's an heterogeneous solution, right? Examples of an heterogeneous solution, sugar water that we have seen, and salt and sand, if you mix it, iron and salt that you mix it, these are all the examples of an heterogeneous mixtures. Fine. In the photograph also you are able to see on the left hand side the copper sulfate solution is there, which is bluish in color and it is uniformly distributed. Where in the other case, iron salt powder and iron particles which are put inside, or if you put a carbon particles also inside, you are not going to see that they are going to mix together. And the black or a brownish color particles in the salt, you are able to completely see inside the beaker on the right hand side. So this is how you can identify the homogeneous and a heterogeneous mixture. In an experiment that we are going to see here, the experiment, the first is the salt one, and in the salt is put inside the water and you see that it is uniformly getting distributed around, right? In the second, see if you are keep seeing that and a spoon is taken off and sugar and put inside the glass and stir up as continuously, you are able to see that it is continuously mixing and you are not able to see the particles getting downward side, right? In the third case, you are seeing that sand particles are taken and put inside the water and it is being stirred up. After a few minutes of time, you are seeing that the sand particles are getting settled at the bottom of it, right? So at the bottom of it, you are seeing more amount of sand and less amount of water. In the middle case, some amount of sand and more amount of water again. And the last phase, at the top phase, you are seeing more amount of water and very less amount of sand. So it's not uniformly distributed. That's why it is called as a heterogeneous mixture. Now we are putting an oil inside the water and stirring, and after a few seconds you are seeing a yellow color at the top of it, which shows that the oil particles have settled down at the top of it because the density is less of oil, and at the top of it you are finding the oil back again. Fine. So two layers are been getting separated, so this is an heterogeneous mixture. So I hope so you have understood about mixtures. Alloy is a type of a mixture, and the separation as an homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. Thank you for